For how long you are having this lipomas?
I've had this for a very long time when I was younger.
Okay.
Back in class 8 or 9.
Okay.
I realized that I have little bumps.
Okay.
And then over the time they've grown. It's genetics. My mom has it, my uncles have it.
They are mainly on the arms or you have in other parts?
I have in other parts. Some, few here on the sides.
Okay.
And then I have a lot on my legs.
So what exact thing you get because of this? Do you feel discrimination? Do you feel a little feel of a little less self-esteem? Or do you feel a little shy because of this? Or you are just comfortable with that?
I've always been very comfortable with that.
Okay.
Right now, what I plan to do is I plan to open a hair studio.
Okay.
In my country. So over there, I also want to practice. So I'm learning. It's my studio, I want to learn the work as well.
Sure.
So I'm taking a course from Tony and Guy, India.
Okay.
Learning to be a hairdresser, a hairstylist.
Okay.
So I've never, like when people would ask me what this is, I would joke around always. So I've never felt less confident. But now since I'm going to be working with my hands, so I can't have this. It looks very odd and bad. The customers, they might not
yeah.
feel comfortable, so that's
yeah.
why
sometimes they ask unnecessary questions, sometimes
yeah.
they keep on, and then they make you realize what is this, why do you don't take treatment.
Yeah.
Actually these are more of a cosmetic value.
I know,
because whenever there are multiple lipomas, chances of them there becoming cancer is negligible, though it can happen but very rare. Only thing is they can start growing very big. If they suddenly start growing big because of the risk of malignancy, because of the pressure symptoms, because of the discomfort, because of the pain, these are few indications which are surgical indication for the removal. And another is social indications.
Yeah.
Now in your case it is more of a social indication because you cannot keep them covered all the time.
No.
Even if you wear something, they will start looking as bumps. They're
yeah.
quite big in size.
Yeah.
Okay. So for this reason we should remove them.
Yeah.
Now the options are either I remove them with a big cut. If I give big cuts, I have to take stitches, and that stitches also sometimes they have tendency to get infected. One, secondly, they have tendency to form the scars.
Yeah.
One scar is of the surgery, whatever big incision we take, and second is of the stitch marks, what from wherever the stitches come and go. Now,
it will leave scars.
It will leave a lot of scar. Now that again is an issue because you have done it for the cosmetic reason, you have another scars. Then again people will ask, itne sare how you got so many scars?
Yeah.
How you got so many injuries?
Yeah.
So you cannot keep on explaining those people. So,
yeah.
so then the options are, then this minimal invasive option comes. Where we go through a very small pinhole, take out the complete lipoma, remove all the extent. People have so many doubt how you remove what. We will be leaving out. We do not leave anything. We remove complete lipoma through this hole. Okay.
But so what is this process called?
This is a special technique which we have devised.
Okay.
I call it micro incision removal of lipoma. Very small incision. We take.
Is it the same with liposuction?
No, it is not.
It
same
is not the same. Okay.
Why it is not same with the liposuction? I cannot do a liposuction for this. If I do liposuction for this, supposingly this is the lipoma. Now I want to remove 1, 2, 3 or 5 all lipoma through one hole. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
If I take one hole, I take the hole here or anywhere. Maybe I can take here only.
Mm-hmm.
I will take one hole and then I will break it in pieces with the hammer.
Oh.
There's a long instrument with which you have to hammer it and break it in small pieces. Then we have made it small pieces. You try to suck it. Lipo means fat breaking and then sucking it out. When you try to suck it, your machine will never be able to completely suck it, and it will spread it different way. And then another mistake, if I start doing tricky incision here and I want to take this lipoma out through this incision,
so the whole fat of this area will be taken as well.
Yes, that's
yeah.
the point. This fat is also going, and now this I break in small pieces, this will spread in this area, and they will, this area which was never there were lipoma will come in this area also.
So liposuction is actually not a good solution for lipomas.
Yes, liposuction is primarily you are breaking it in many pieces and then try to collect them out.
Mm.
Here aim is to try to collect as much lipoma as one piece or smaller pieces which through the same hole.
Okay.
Not creating, I want to remove this also through this, or I want to remove this also through this. This is a wrong technique. Technically, it is not good for the patient. Sometimes I get patients who have done the liposuction, they had 3-4 lipomas, and I'm like you. When they do the liposuction, they break it, it spreads everywhere. If I want to try, and that is not an issue. Okay, by just you have spread the lipoma, I say, okay, we can remove again. But spreading is okay, but if I put that long instrument all the way, there are so many nerves, blood vessels. If I try to hammer them with that pipe, and it can injure them. If it causes the injury, they can bleed. They will form the black patches. Okay, one. Second is, there are nerves which can get injured. And then you will get somewhere numbness here. Maybe you will get discomfort, mobility issues, lack of strength. That all are possible. Okay. Rarely, if this lipoma is sitting on a nerve and it is attached to that, if I am separating, then I can, there is a chance I can get little bit of numbness in some area. But that's acceptable. But for if the lipoma is not on the nerve and we are still creating a numbness for anyone or creating a problem for somebody, it's not a good idea. And technically, I do not recommend that either. If it's better to have complete scar rather than doing a liposuction. At least you are working only in this area. You are not hammering, injuring this area. You are not injuring all this area. You just go. Whatever you do.
So that's the traditional way. Take it out, stitch it out.
That's better than at least liposuction.
Yeah, understand.
Either we remove through a very small hole, same thing,
mm-hmm.
the same site. Not, I will never try to remove this lipoma through this hole. Because this is technically not good for the patient, not recommended. Okay. So hopefully, within short time, we will remove all of them for you. I know you have many, but everyone do not have the same budget at one time to remove everything in one go. Second is, sometimes patients have 200, 300 lipomas. I also personally tell them, don't do all of them in one go. First remove 50, 60, maybe 100 also you can remove. But
the ones that are mostly uncomfortable.
Mostly uncomfortable. And second is, too long surgery is also not good for you. So we should remove as many as we can keep you comfortable. Without causing any discomfort or without causing any complication. This is a cosmetic thing. Though I understand for you it is a social indication also. It's not just social, it is because of your
work
relationship also. Professional indication is also there. But still, for that, we cannot give you a complication which is not acceptable.
Thank you.
Okay? Our aim should be to completely cure it and with negligible recurrence. I never say zero recurrence. Still, sometimes what happens is recurrence is not there. What happens is this is a big lipoma. Surrounding this, there is 2 mm, 3 mm lipoma is lying down. Whatever is visible, I will take it out. Maybe that will grow over the years. If that grows, it will take a number of years. When it grows, then
we will again. We can add.
Yeah.
Some.
Right now, I said that there are these. Now we have noticed one very small here. You can know. Nobody can. If you
see, be able to see,
but with my finger I can feel, but it is so small. This right now we don't need to remove it.
Okay.
Any doubts in mind?
No, sir. I've researched about you. Like when before coming here to India, I looked best doctor for lipoma removal, and then your name came on top. So, and then I read the reviews. They're pretty good. So I'm also very satisfied with your. Explanations. Thank you.
So how are you feeling now?
Lighter. Better.
Okay.
I feel good.
Feeling good. So where are the lipomas now? You are missing them?
Very much.
Why you miss those lipomas?
First of all, it was they were my companions.
Okay.
And sometimes when I'm bored, I could play with them. And then I could also joke around with people. I told my wife the first time I met her, I told her that I got a reaction from her, got her attention with my lipoma. So they helped me get her attention.
Cute lipoma story, can you tell us?
Oh, so when I met my wife for the first time, so I showed her my lipomas and told her that, hey, I have cancers and I'm dying in 3 months.
Oh.
And then I got her attention and she looked very sad and she spoke to me in a very kind manner. And then it was very easy to charm her in the next half an hour. And then I told her. And then she got angry and also relieved that I'm actually not dying.
Okay. So that's why you call them cute lipomas.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good. So we are.
I think she called them cute lipomas.
Oh, my wife called. She found my lipomas very cute.
Okay.
So later when I told her that it's just lipoma, it's fat, and later she told me after we got married, she often would see my lipomas and tell them that they're very cute.
Very cute.
Because that was the starting point of your love story.
Could be, yeah.
Yeah.
I thought that maybe it will, to get one lipoma out, I will maybe, there will be a bigger scar or something, but it's just a little, a pencil dot, like scar. So, like, a hole.
Small hole. Very
small
hole.
Very small hole, and the lipoma got out from there. And it surprised me, and I feel good. In a good way. It surprised me in a good way.
Good. Any moment, if you can show, you can lift everything. You're feeling strong, same strong as before.
Yeah, I feel, like I said, my hands feel lighter.
Okay.
And no discomfort yet. Nothing. And I think I can pretty much do anything.
Okay.
So.
So you want to see how the lipomas have come, how big they are. These are the complete lipomas which have been removed. They actually, we deliver them. They are one piece. We are not breaking them in very small pieces.
Okay.
We don't want to make them spread them.
Okay.
They are almost delivered like a baby.
Okay.
And what another thing which you had taken some massage also. If you can tell about that, what therapy you were doing about them.
Okay.
This is almost this. You can see this is one complete lipoma. So this is one piece lipoma, not very small chunks and breaking them in small pieces. It is not liposuction, because whenever we are doing, I told you what exactly happens. You also tried to do liposuction also initially, or somebody suggested you?
One of them wanted to do an open surgery where you cut, take it out and then stitch it up. And then another doctor suggested liposuction, which I initially thought you would do, because I did not know the ways how you perform.
Okay.
I would like to say one thing that I had no idea that you're not supposed to massage the lipomas or like rub them, because what I would do is whenever I was bored or even in my unconscious mind, sometimes I would just grab them, rub them, move my fingers around them, play with them.
Okay.
So you told me during my surgery that you should not do that, because it what happens is
whenever you are pressing a lipoma,
yeah,
you are doing some injury in that area. You are trying to unnecessarily mobilize it. Whenever you are pressing or trying to crush it, it causes inflammatory reaction.
Yeah.
On the surrounding skin. Now gradually they tend to become hard and they tend to stick on the surrounding skin, so it creates a inflammatory reaction. And whenever that inflammatory reaction subsides, it creates the fibrosis. Now that lipoma become more difficult to remove. Our aim should be to completely recover. Though we can remove them also in a very nice manner with the experience, but they are not easy to remove.
Okay.
You will also get discomfort during removing them. If they are on the nerves, they will. If the lipoma is here and this is lipoma, this is the nerve. Okay, and we can easily remove them. But if you have created a lot of fibrosis, lot of inflammation around this lipoma, so it can cause problem to the nerve also.
Okay.
So that is the reason I recommend, don't squeeze them, don't play with them, and don't rub with them.
I will
and
try
some people to
my
take
best.
Massage also.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. And another thing is, there are
I've still got a lot of lipomas, which I will get out in the next session. I will try not to play with them.
Yeah, try not to play with them. It's out of habit, maybe you are doing that. But what happens is, maximum is your right hand was able to reach this side.
Yeah.
Very nicely, and you were able to grab them,
yeah,
harden them. But with the left, you were not playing that much, because you are a right-handed.
Yeah.
And left hand lipomas were actually cute lipomas. They were easy to come out. But the right hand were It had become very tough and you can say inflamed lipomas.
Yeah.
That took us a little more time than the routine.
Yeah, I had more lipomas on my right hand,
but
the left hand took longer.
Yeah, you know yourself.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Thank you for so much information.
No worries. Thank you for all the help that you've done.